In this video, I'm going to be talking about the recent Nintendo Direct and giving my thoughts and opinions. I'm going to talk about every single announcement in this Nintendo Direct. So let's go ahead and start the video. First of all, I'm actually going to talk about the biggest announcement in this Nintendo Direct. I'm not actually going to beat around the bush. The biggest announcement from this Nintendo Direct is the fact that we are getting a Smash Brothers game on the Nintendo Switch, and I am a big Smash Brothers fan, and I don't want to make this video all about Smash, so I'm just going to run over the Smash really quickly. I might make a separate video talking about Smash on Switch because I love Smash to death. I played them all. I love that fighting series. I'm just a big fan of Smash Brothers. Now, we did get a teaser from the Nintendo Direct on the Smash series. It showed off the Inklings from the Splatoon series, and they are coming to Smash. A lot of speculations are saying this might be a Smash 4 port because Nintendo is porting over a lot of Wii U games to the Switch, and for obvious reasons it makes sense. Do I think this is a new Smash Brothers game, or do I think this is a remake of Smash 4 or a port? Honestly, I think this might be more closer to a new game just because the trailer is just too hype, and at this point if they announced a Smash 4 port, I don't think it would make too much sense because a lot of fans would be disappointed after seeing that teaser. I can't deny that teaser, even though they only showed off the Inklings, it was just too hype, and at this point I would be kind of like shocked if they showed Smash 4. If you ask me which one do I want more, do I want a Smash 4 port or do I want a Smash 5 game or a Smash Switch game, obviously I'd want a new one, but having Smash 4 on the Switch wouldn't be bad because in my opinion, I absolutely love the Smash 4 game. I thought the Smash 4 game on the Wii U was one of my favorite Smash games of all time. Yes, I'm saying it right now. I know it might offend some of you and you might be mad, but honestly, I love that game and I don't have a problem with it being on the Switch because I still play that game. That's primarily why I still own my Wii U, and the fact I still turn on my Wii U, that and Super Mario Maker. So it would make sense to put that on. We would pretty much get new content and we would get a new online infrastructure since we are getting that new online paid service from Nintendo. The online's got to be much more better than it is on the Wii U. So porting that game over to the Switch, I would still be down for that and I still would buy that. But either way, I'm okay with what they do, whether they go to a new Smash game or whether they go to a Smash 4 port. Either way, I'm okay with that. And I know a lot of people aren't okay with the Smash 4 port because I know some people didn't like Smash 4 or some people are drained of Smash 4. So I get that as well. But just those are just my thoughts. Don't care which one comes as long as we get one, because it's going to be cool to actually play this on the go, play this on the TV, new online infrastructure, some new characters, some new things in it overall. I'm very excited for this. I'll probably make a totally separate video just talking about Smash Switch. So now I have my phone here because there is a lot of information on this recent Nintendo Direct. So let's go ahead and go over each and every announcement that it was announced in this Nintendo Direct. Now, first and foremost, they did show off a lot of 3DS titles. I'm still surprised the 3DS is getting as much support as it's getting. As you know, the 3DS is pretty much very, very old at this time. There's got to be a point to where they're just going to discontinue the 3DS and they're going to stop making games for it. But right now, it looks like we're still getting games pumped to the 3DS. And here's my thoughts on that. I know some people are okay with it, some people don't like it. I'm in the boat to where I really don't like it at this point because after playing the Switch, I really don't want to migrate back to my 3DS. The 3DS screen is not the same quality as the Switch, and going back from the Switch, going from the Switch to the 3DS kind of bothers me at this point in time. I know graphics don't necessarily matter, and I'm a person that doesn't really necessarily care about graphics and old graphics don't really bother me. I am a retro gamer, but for some reason, it just for me personally, I know it sounds crazy, it's just hard for me to go back to the 3DS. The 3DS is not even an HD console, it's sub-HD, and those screens don't even compare to what we have on the Nintendo Switch. Especially, of course, if you're playing your Nintendo Switch on a TV, of course, it does not compare in either form. It just does not compare, so I'm a little disappointed that they're still showing off 3DS games. But I understand they still need to support the 3DS. They promised they were going to support the 3DS, and they did. I thought it would just be at least 1 year, but they're actually extending it to this year, and I think there's a couple games coming out next year. I am kind of surprised, but of course, there's about 70 to 80 million units already floating around of the 3DS at this point in time, so it makes sense they want to try to get as many sales as possible before they discontinue the 3DS line of systems. So let's talk about the 3DS news on the Nintendo Direct. First of all, we got WarioWare Gold. WarioWare Gold is pretty much WarioWare Inc., I do believe, from the Game Boy Advance. They're pretty much just adding new mini games to that, so it's going to be a much more bigger game. I am a fan of the WarioWare games, the actual games, not the WarioWare, not the WarioLand games, the WarioWare games. The WarioWare games are just pretty much a compilation of really quick mini games. They're not the same quality as Mario Party mini games. I want to make that clear if you never played them. The WarioWare games are pretty much these little simple games. Like, for instance, you may, on one game, pick someone's nose. You may be swinging a bat at a baseball. And they're these really quick challenges. And after you complete these really quick mini games, you're faced with a boss. And it's a rinse and repeat cycle. You play about 20 mini games, beat them. You face a boss, play about 20 mini games, you face a boss, and that's pretty much it. But those games are actually fun, and it's a really fun series, so you should highly check it out since it is coming to the Nintendo 3DS. It's coming to the 3DS on August 3rd, the WarioWare Gold compilation. They're adding more content to the game anyway. Next up, for the 3DS, we have Dylan's Dead Heat Breakers coming May 24th. Now, Dylan's Rolling Western was actually a game on the 3DS. It was an indie game. I don't know too much about this game, so I'm not really going to talk about too much of this game. I heard it was an okay game. It was pretty fun, but I just don't really know about Dylan's Rolling Western. But here's Dylan's Dead Heat Breakers coming May 24th on the 3DS. Now let's move on to Mario and Luigi, Bowser's Inside Story, and Bowser Jr.'s Journey. So it looks like they're pretty much just taking Bowser's Inside Story from the DS and they're porting it over to the 3DS. That's great. It really does seem like we're getting a lot of Mario and Luigi's games. We got Mario and Luigi's Superstar Saga that came out last year for the 3DS. Now we're getting Bowser's Inside Story. So it looks like if you want a lot of Mario and Luigi games, you can turn to the 3DS. The 3DS has plenty of Mario and Luigi's games. Honestly, I like some of the Mario and Luigi's game, but I feel like I'm kind of burnt out of that series. But Bowser's Inside Story was actually one of the better Mario and Luigi games, in my opinion. So if you haven't played Bowser's Inside Story, you should definitely check out Bowser's Inside Story. And the fact we are getting Bowser Jr.'s Journey alongside of it, some extra content. That's nice. So you're getting some extra additional content. It looks like there is no true release date, but it looks like it is coming in 2019, but we don't have a solid release date, just a 2019 release date. Next up on the 3DS, and this one actually pains me to say this is on the 3DS. I wish this was not on the 3DS. I'm talking about Luigi's Mansion 3DS remake. I wish this was on the Switch. It would only make sense if this was on the Switch because the graphics of the 3DS are not great. They're not even HD. And the screens are very small on the 3DS. And the fact you can't even play this on your TV pains me more. A lot of people have been saying that the Luigi's Mansion original game from the GameCube is actually better than the Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon that we got on the 3DS, and I've never played the original. I have played Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon, and personally, I did not like that game at all. I actually did play the first mansion in that game, but after that, I just did not like the game. Maybe it was the fact that it was on the 3DS, and maybe I didn't like the controls, maybe I didn't like the graphics. Something with me did not just click with the Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon game, but people are saying that game is much more better than that, so I may end up checking this game out, and it pains me to go back to the 3DS. Why Nintendo? This is one I wish was really on the Nintendo Switch more than any other game that's been on the 3DS. I wish this game was coming to the Switch. It would look so good in HD. Why Nintendo? Why put this on the 3DS? Sure, there's Dark Moon, but why? And the fact that we got much more better controls on the Switch only makes sense. Why put this on 3DS? It is what it is, but it looked like there's no release date for this, but a 2018 release date, so that's it. But we still don't have a solid release date for the Luigi's Mansion 3DS remake. Now let's go ahead and talk about all the Switch news, because there is plenty of Switch news to talk about in this Nintendo Direct. First of all, we are getting a remake of Okami HD. Don't know too much about that game. I think it's some kind of RPG. Don't know what console it was on. Don't know anything about that game. But if you know about that game, great. And if you're a big fan of that game, it's coming out summer 2018, the Okami HD remake for the Switch. Next up, we are getting a Dark Souls amiibo. That's kind of strange because a lot of people out there are saying it really doesn't fit as an amiibo, and I will agree, it's kind of an odd choice for an amiibo, but it's great that they're actually supporting the Dark Souls series. And I will have to say, even though they just announced that in the actual Nintendo Direct, I am pretty excited for the Dark Souls remaster coming to the Nintendo Switch. It's coming out, I think, sometime in May, and they're also going to be doing a test beta for the game, and I am very excited for that game because I never played a Dark Souls game. I know, hate me right now, but I am going to end up picking that up because right now I'm still trying to beat Bloodborne. So there's that. So I'm very excited for Dark Souls. Next up, we do have Sushi Striker, The Way of the Sushido, coming out June 8th, and it's going to be coming out on the Switch as well as the 3DS, because if you remember last year, I still remember this game. This is one game I still remember, and I was still asking myself, where is this game? Sure, it's not a very big game, and it's probably one a lot of people overlooked, but I still remember this game, and I was like, where is this game? But finally, they are finally releasing it, and instead of just releasing it for the 3DS, they said, nope, let's just release it multi-plat. So they're giving a 3DS and a Switch version for Sushi Striker. The next game is Octopath Traveler. We finally have a release date for the turn-based RPG from Square. It's going to be coming out July 13th. And this one, I'm kind of on the fence on. I kind of do want to play a new turn-based RPG. And this one looks like it fits the bill. I have played the demo for Octopath Traveler. And the one thing that I'm not too really sure how I feel about the game is the art style of the game. If you don't know anything about Octopath Traveler, Octopath Traveler is a game from Square that's a turn-based RPG. And it really does have a very different art style than a lot of other RPGs you will ever play. So I'm not too sure about the art style of the game. I need to really just play the demo again and see how I'm going to like this game. But I want to give this game a fair chance because it looks like it has some really great mechanics that not a lot of other RPGs has. It looks like it's doing something very cool with the turn-based elements. There's some really cool gimmicks, some really cool things in that game. I just don't know how I feel about the art style of the game. Moving on, we got No More Heroes, Travis Barker's. Never really touched that series, but I heard it was a really good series back on the Wii, and a lot of people like the No More Heroes games. I'm sure it's going to do really well. There's no solid release date for that game. It looks like it's coming out in 2018. There's that. Next up, we got another port. I know people are tired of hearing ports for the Nintendo Switch, but ports aren't necessarily bad, and it pretty much means more games for the Switch. How can you complain about more games? More games, the better. And if you haven't already played these games on the Wii U, then just don't buy these games if you already played them or you don't want to play them again. But the next game we are getting is actually going to be a port for the Switch, but it's actually going to be a multi-plat port. It's not just coming to the Switch, it's actually coming to the 3DS as well. So they are putting this game to two different platforms. So if you don't have a Switch yet, you're still in luck. You can actually play this on the 3DS, and actually it might be very cool on the 3DS. We're getting a port of Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, and it's coming out July 13th, and it's coming out for 3DS and the Nintendo Switch. And the thing about this game is, since it is a puzzle game and there is a lot of 3D involved, I think this would work very good on the 3DS. So it's not necessarily to say you should just buy this on the Switch. Maybe you should give this game a look on the 3DS, because I can see this game being a really good 3D game. This might take very good effect of the 3D effect of the 3DS, and it might actually help you with some of the puzzles in the game. Overall, this is a very solid game, and I think this is one game on the Nintendo Wii U that did not come out at full price. It only came out at $40, so if you were to buy this game, I'm assuming it's not going to be too high, even on Switch. It's only going to be like a budget release. It's only going to be like $40. Honestly, of course, the Captain Toad game came from Super Mario 3D World. I hope they still port Super Mario 3D World. That is absolutely one of my favorite Super Mario 3D games out there, so I do hope they port Super Mario 3D World over to Switch. I will buy that in an instant. Is it the best 3D Mario game? Of course, not by far. Is it even better than Super Mario Galaxy 1 and 2 or even Super Mario 64? Honestly, I'm going to say probably not, because it is very linear. You're not really collecting stars to progress. You're just going through level. It's kind of pretty much a 2D Mario and a 3D Mario combined. That is what Super Mario 3D World is. But I hope now that they ported Captain Toad, which pretty much came from Super Mario 3D World, they'll port 3D World over to the Switch. I'm going to buy that in an instant because I've actually ran that game multiple times. I think I have 4 or 5 playthroughs of that game, and I wouldn't mind just playing that on the go on the Switch. That is a very fun game to me, at least, and I love that game. So make it happen, Nintendo. The next one we're getting does not have any release date, not even a year. It just says to be announced. We are getting Undertale. Undertale is actually a very good game. A lot of people compare Undertale to Earthbound. They have a lot of similarities, Earthbound and Undertale. Undertale is an RPG. It has really good music. It has a really fun gameplay. Overall, definitely check out Undertale. Don't disregard this game if you never played it. It is a very wacky game. It is very unusual, but definitely check out Undertale. Undertale is going to be released for the Nintendo Switch. And if you haven't checked out Undertale and you don't want to wait, you can buy that on PC, I think. It's already been out for a couple of years now, so go ahead and play Undertale if you haven't already played Undertale. The next one we're getting, which I am very, very excited for, 100%, we are getting a port of Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy, and it's coming out July 10th, so it's coming out this summer. Why am I very excited for this? Yes, I own a PlayStation 4. Yes, I've already owned this game. I got it on release date on the PS4, but I'm excited because I'm much more lean towards Nintendo nowadays than I do any other console. And the fact that you can actually take this on the go now is a big deal to me. And the fact that Crash Bandicoot, I've said this many times, maybe you're a new subscriber of me, or maybe you just stumbled on this video, but I did grow up with the Crash Bandicoot series, and if I can show Activision or whoever made this game some love, I'm going to throw them a bone, because I hope we get some new Crash Bandicoot games, and I love this series, and this series is a solid series overall. There's nothing wrong with the Crash Bandicoot games. If you love your platforming games, you cannot go wrong with this game. And the fact that this game on release on the PS4 anyway was $40 is absolutely a steal for this game. I hope on Nintendo Switch it's going to be $40, because I know there's a lot of games on Nintendo Switch that tend to go up in price for some odd reason. So I hope this stays at $40. Even if it goes to $60, I'm willing to pay the full price for this game, because in this collection you are getting the first 3 Crash Bandicoot games. So there's a lot of content. You're getting Crash Bandicoot 1, Crash Bandicoot Cortex Strikes Back, and Crash Bandicoot 3 Warped. So you are getting a lot of content. I think this is one collection you should not overlook, especially if you're a fan of platformers, or especially if you're a person that wants to play their games on the go. I think this fits perfectly on the Nintendo Switch. So that's a very good collection. The next one we are getting is Little Nightmares Complete Edition on May 18th. Don't know too much about Little Nightmares, so I can't comment on Little Nightmares. Maybe you know much more about Little Nightmares, but I know pretty much nothing about Little Nightmares. Next up, we are getting a port. Yes, a port. Now, this was speculated to be coming to the Nintendo Switch anyway, so it's not really like it was a surprise to a lot of people, but we are getting a port of South Park The Fractured Butthole, which came out last year to other platforms. We are getting it April 21st. I think that there was a collection of the first game and the Fractured Butthole. I don't know how true that is, and I can't confirm that. I don't know why they didn't give us both games. Maybe they should have just gave us both games, but either way, we are getting the Fractured Butthole on the Nintendo Switch, and that's very good news, because a lot of people have said these are very good games. They're not just some really bad TV-related games. They're actually very fun games, so maybe I'll check them out. I know I'm not really a South Park fan too much. I do respect South Park, and I don't really hate it too much. When it's on, I'll watch it, but I'm not like a hardcore fan, is pretty much what I'm saying. I don't watch it all the time. I watch it from time to time, but I do respect it, and I like it. Maybe I'll give this game a chance. Next up, they did announce that ARMS is getting an online, some kind of tournament anyway for ARMS. So if you're ARMS, you should check that tournament out. Not really too much of big news. The next one we are getting is we do have a concrete release date for Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. If you haven't picked up Hyrule Warriors by now, you might as well pick it up on Switch, because this is going to be the definitive version of Hyrule Warriors on the Nintendo Switch. It's pretty much going to be taking every content from the Wii U and 3DS version of Hyrule Warriors. It's coming out May 18th, so if you want to buy it, you can get it on May 18th. The next one, we do have a solid concrete release date for Mario Tennis Aces. It's coming out June 22nd. Now, this is one game I actually disregarded, because when I first saw it, I just said, well, this must be another tennis game. And we've had a lot of Mario Tennises in the past, and the last one on Wii U was a disaster. They pretty much just threw that out at the last second to try to get one last buck for the Nintendo Wii U before the Wii U set off into the sunset. And that's pretty much how that Mario Tennis game felt on the Wii U. But now this is pretty much that game that they probably wanted to make on the Wii U on the Nintendo Switch. And I didn't really care for it when I first saw the reveal for that game. But now that we have more information, I'm kind of thinking I kind of want to buy Mario Tennis Aces. It looks like it has some really cool things. The one thing I love about Mario and Mario Tennis Aces is the fact that you can actually break someone's tennis racket, so it does give a lot of replayability and it does give a lot of strategy. There's actually more strategy in this game than I actually first thought there was going to be, and I think this is a game that I'm... Okay, I do apologize, the camera actually cut out, but I'm going to keep on rolling. What I'm saying is, I do think this game actually has a lot of strategy behind this game, and I am very excited to check this game out, and I like a lot of the mechanics they showed off in the Nintendo Direct. Not going to go over a lot of the mechanics, but I absolutely think this might be a game worth picking up, and I do like a lot of the Mario Tennis, not Mario Tennis, excuse me, I do like a lot of the Mario Sports games. Of course, I like some of the tennis games as well, but I do like Mario Sports games, and this one looks like it might be really fun to play, and the mechanic just looks absolutely fun, and the fact this could be a very good, fun, competitive game to play online with the mechanics they showed off in this game. The next thing up is we have pretty much the rest of it is just Splatoon content. We got Splatoon version 3.0. They pretty much just showed off some updates for new gear, new content, new maps, and things like that. But then we actually got an actual true DLC, true paid DLC. This is the first time we got paid DLC for the Splatoon series. Splatoon 2 is getting paid DLC. Now the DLC, I think you can actually pre-order today, I think they announced. And the DLC is pretty much going to be stuff geared towards single player content. So we're getting more story-based content for Splatoon 2. And the thing is, you're also going to be getting some gear you can actually use online when you purchase this single player paid DLC for Splatoon 2. From what I saw in the trailer, these are just my opinions. From what I saw in the trailer, honestly, I personally don't think at this point in time it's worth $20 to pick up this DLC. $20 seems kind of expensive. And as you know, the Splatoon single player in Splatoon 2 is not that great. It's pretty much the same Splatoon experience you played in Splatoon 1 when it comes to the single player content. And the single player content is not that great in my opinion. It's just like tacked on. It's fun. There's fun to be had. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying the Splatoon games have bad single player content or bad story based content. There's some fun to be had, but I don't think the level of the single player content is up to par, and I don't think it's worth paying $20. Honestly, I still think I need more information on this Splatoon 2 paid DLC. Once there's more information on this Splatoon 2 paid DLC, I think I might want to buy it, but at this point in time, I just think $20 is just way too high for this Splatoon 2 paid DLC, especially since it's mostly single player content, and I really don't dabble my feet into this Splatoon series single player story based content because this is not that fun in my opinion anyway. So I don't know how I feel about it. I'm not going to disregard it. I just need more information on this, and I need to see how I feel about paying $20 for this thing, because also it's a one and done. Once you beat this, it's pretty much done, so really what's the point? And like I said before, Splatoon never really focused too much on the single player content, and it wasn't amazing or to where it blew my mind or anything like that, so I don't know how I feel about that. And yeah, that's pretty much all they announced in this Nintendo Direct. Overall, like I said, this was a great Nintendo Direct. I liked a lot about this Nintendo Direct. Some games I didn't really care too much about, some games I'm very happy about, and obviously I'm very happy about the Super Smash Brothers reveal for the Switch. Anyway, guys, this is Wayne from MyTech News, signing out.